everybody. It's Anne from Annalise Creates, Annalise Creations. I'm here to do the Documented Life Project, and May theme was touchy-feely texture for May 30th, which is, I think, the week 21 or 22, something like that. I'll figure it out later and put it in the title of this video. And the art challenge for this week was textured paper, and journal prompt is I'm so not feeling it, okay? So I figured what I did was as I took my Big Shot and used one of my embossing folders. I think this is a Tim Holtz embossing folder. I'm not sure what the name of it is, but it's kind of cool. It's kind of like the blueprint patterns. So I went ahead and embossed it on some kind of flimsy cardstock paper. And so now I'm going to tear one of these out. And I went ahead and colored the paper with the Stazon, the Saddle Brown. Okay. So I'm going to rip one of these out. And I'm not sure where I'm going with this page yet. I'm not feeling it. Well, I'm not feeling it. So I think I'm going to put this down first and kind of go from there. And I'm going to be using not one of my good brushes this time because I want the texture to show on everything. And I did that with putting this down and some of the, this is a really cheapy brush, and some of the hairs from the brush actually stuck to the paper. To the page when I was gessoing this page, so I think it'll add some extra texture to this. Okay, so that is down, and it's actually kind of coloring the page as well by going over it with some matte medium. This is going to be interesting. That. So I've got this, I don't know, it was from some packaging. It's corrugated paper. It's not corrugated cardboard like you would find here, but it's corrugated paper. So I figured I'd find a place to put that down. And then next, I had bought some drywall joint tape. I'll tell you a funny story. My husband's so old school, okay? I was trying to ask him, okay, where? We went to Home Depot the other day to get some pool supplies, and we get there, and I'm asking him, well, where do they keep the drywall tape? And he's like, okay, they keep it where the paint area is. Okay, so we get there. And he's looking and looking, and I'm saying, it looks like a mesh. It looks like mesh. And he's like, no, it doesn't. It's metal. It's like a tape, like a metallic tape, or, you know, almost like a masking tape. And I said, no, it's a mesh tape, like, you know, don't you know where that is, what that is? Well, then, you know, he's looking, and then he found the tape. He goes, is this what you're talking about? I said, yes. He goes, oh, I didn't even know they made this stuff. He goes, this must be new. And I said, yeah, it must be new to you, because he's, yeah. So now that he knows, so now I'm trying to find the end of this, though. I can't find the end of the tape. So do I cut into it then? I don't know. This is interesting because I can't seem to find the end to the tape. Where do you find the end? Okay. And I know I only have 21 minutes left on my charge, and I would like to get this done today, and I may not if my camera goes out. Okay, so I'm trying to find the end of the tape. Okay, well, I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. So I tore out a piece. I've got this old vintage ledger from like the 1890s, and it had some cool calligraphy white writing in it, so I thought I would use a piece of it for this. And using that brush again, because I want, you know, texture for this page. I'm just sort of going with the flow here. And I've got some jelly printed paper, deli paper, that I'm going to add to this too. And I'm not worried about the paper not going perfectly flat for this one, because I want the texture. So I'm doing it on purpose where there's some wrinkles in the paper. Sorry, guys. I don't like this one, so I'm going to dry this off first. Okay, so first I'm going to use some aluminum paste. I'm using a piece of parchment paper this time. Usually I have wax paper around, but I don't know what I did with it. My art room is a mess today, I have to tell you. A huge mess. So I'm going to mix it, and then I'll turn my camera here so you can see what I'm doing with mixing it. Get a better angle. There we go. That's as good as it's going to get at the moment. And I probably should have gotten a different thing of paper for this. Since it's curling up on me. Okay. So I'm going to get some modeling paste here. And I'm going to take some of the green, and I'm going to mix it into there. If I can find what I need to get. Don't want to use the palette knife because it's already, whoops. Okay. And I'm going to mix it together. Color the modeling paste as much as I can with this. There we go. And I'm going to use one of my stencils that I made. I cut out using my Cameo silhouette. I think I made this from one of my Art Deco pictures that I had. I like the shape, I think, that I turned it into a stencil. Whoops, it's moving. Dang it. Okay, let's see if I can get this. Uh-oh, I have 8 minutes left on this charge. I'm gonna probably have to quit in a minute and recharge my battery and come back later to finish recording this video. Well, that's good anyways, because this modeling paste needs to dry first before I finish doing anything else. This modeling paste will have to dry. I mean, I could dry it with my heat gun, but I think I'm going to just let it dry on its own since I got to charge up my battery. So I'm going to lift this up and hope it worked. And it sorted it. Okay, so that's going to dry, and then I'll be back later. So, I shall see you in a little while. Bye. Hi, everybody. I'm back. So, here is what I did. I was trying to get some of this done because, yeah, I'm limited on time today. So, after the modeling paste dried, I took my Stabilo All pencil and went around the modeling paste shapes. And then I outlined these shapes from the jelly paper. And next, I'm going to add some more stuff to the paper. So, enjoy my process. I'm going to fast forward through the rest of this, okay? So I don't bore you guys to tears, okay?